Hi students, today we are starting a new chapter in your NCERT syllabus, that is motion in a straight line. This chapter comes under a main branch of physics called mechanics. It has three sub-branches. They are statics, kinematics and dynamics. Mechanics is the study of rest and motion of a body under the action of various forces. Statics deals with the study of material body at rest under the action of forces in equilibrium. A body at rest is under the action of various forces, but they are in equilibrium. That is, they are called balanced forces. So, what is the meaning of balanced force or forces in equilibrium? To explain that, we consider a body lying on the surface. Here the surface is shown and a body is placed on it. M is the mass of the body and it is at rest. But there are some forces acting on it. What are the forces there? One of the forces acting on the body is the gravitational force. That is the force exerted by the earth on the body. And it is always in downward direction and is called weight of the body and is given by the equation W is equal to m into g, where m is the mass of the body and g is the acceleration due to gravity. At the same time, there is one more force, and that force is exerted by the surface on the body, and this force is equal and opposite to the gravitational force. That is, the direction of this force is upward, and this force is called a normal reaction, represented by N. Since the body is at rest, we can say these two forces are equal and opposite. So we can write N equal to mg. Okay, and we can call these forces as balanced force, or we can say these forces are in equilibrium. That is, the forces are said to be in equilibrium when they are acting on a body and they are equal and opposite. That means the net effect of the force is zero. Under this force, the body is in equilibrium or body is at rest. Okay, next one is kinematics. It deals with the study of motion of a body without being considering the cause of motion. There are so many reasons behind the motion of a body, but we are not considering the causes or what are the reason for the motion of the body. Okay, the branch which deals with the study of motion only without considering the cause is called kinematics. Is in we are only dealing with the types of motion executed by the body and also the quantities involved in that particular type of motion. Okay. And the third sub-branch is dynamics. It deals with the study of motion of a material body by considering the cause of motion. We know that so many reasons are there behind the motion of a body. Okay, in this branch we are considering what also the reason behind the motion also. Okay, and that branch which deals with the study of motion by considering the cause is called dynamics. But this chapter called motion in a straight line actually comes under kinematics. Means in this branch we are dealing with the motion of a material body only without considering the cause of motion. Okay, now we can explain two important terms in the chapter called rest and motion. First, we can study about rest. We can say a body is at rest if it does not change its position with the time and also with the surroundings. You consider an example here. A person is sitting on the bench and you are observing its position from 10 a.m. to 10.5 a.m. Okay, and in that observation, we saw that his position is not changing with the time. That means 10 to 10.5. its position is not changing. With respect to what? With respect to time and also with respect to its surroundings. His surrounding means the bench on which he is sitting. So with respect to the bench, his position is not changing. So we can say he is at rest. Okay. Next one is motion. We can say a body is in motion if it changes its position continuously with the time and also with the surroundings. You just consider the car shown in the video. You can see its position is goes on changing. So we can say the car is in motion. Okay, now we can stop here and we will discuss the other points in the next class. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.